What's up, everybody? It's the Beastly Gamer here, and today I'm going to show you guys how to utilize SharePlay on the PlayStation 4. It's pretty straightforward and pretty simple. I'm going to show you guys right now. So if you're in a game like The Evil Within and you want to share your gameplay with another player, you hit the share button in the top left of the PS4 controller. Now, previously there were three icons here, now there are four. You can upload a video clip, you can upload a screenshot, you can broadcast your gameplay on Twitch or Ustream, or you can start SharePlay. So I'm going to mock this experience now. I'm not really going to do it because I'm not in a party, but I'm going to show you guys how you do it. You hit the X button on Start SharePlay. You'll get a little privacy icon with some information about privacy. You can find out what SharePlay is, but if you already know exactly what it is, you can hit that OK button. Okay, currently there are no players in my party. Invite someone to the party so I can SharePlay. It's going to ask me to do that. You go into your friends. I'm going to get an error here because I haven't joined a party. But there's all your buddies. You can invite someone to SharePlay if you'd like, and then they can be in your party and enjoy the gaming experience with you. So let's go back to the SharePlay screen. As you guys can see in the top right there, I am actually in SharePlay right now. There's no one in my party, but I do have all the functions. I can stop SharePlay now. I can take back my controller. I can give the controller to a visitor. Now, there are a few things about SharePlay I want to tell you guys about so you know exactly what you can expect. There is a 60-minute time limit on SharePlay. So after an hour, SharePlay will end, but you can immediately start it right back again with the same party. So it's a minute lapse in SharePlay functionality. I think they did that just to keep the system intact rather than let SharePlay run for hours and hours and hours. So after an hour of letting someone play the game, it will stop SharePlay, but you can start it back immediately. Another thing that people didn't know about SharePlay is the resolution and frame rate for the visitor is going to be capped. If you're playing a game on PS4 and that game is running at 1080p, the person visiting or playing that game from their home is only going to see a maximum resolution of 720p. So they're going to get a 720p experience. Also, the frame rate will be capped. I guess that varies as per your internet connection and the game that you are playing. Also, when you're doing share play, the person visiting will not be able to get any of your personal information. They will not be able to see screens on your PS4. They'll only be able to play the game. Also, your notifications and messages will not be able to be seen by the person visiting, and they will not have the authority to turn off your PS4 or anything of that nature. So SharePlay is pretty simple. I think it's an awesome thing that Sony has added. Also, in SharePlay, as you guys can see here, that PlayStation Plus icon, when you give the controller to a visitor, there's a PlayStation Plus icon up there for a reason. Now, you're probably wondering why. All the functionalities of SharePlay are not totally free. Now, if you're playing a game like The Evil Within, and you want to share that with someone, then you can give the controller to that person. They will not need PlayStation Plus. It is a single-player game experience, and it does not have any local co-op. Now, if you have a game that you're playing that has local co-op, like Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls Edition, and you'd like one of your friends to join you on your PlayStation 4 locally, that person, as well as you, is going to need PlayStation Plus. So it all depends on the type of game that you're playing. If you're playing a game that you want another person to join you and play, you're both going to need PlayStation Plus. But if you're playing a game like The Evil Within or Assassin's Creed or Infamous Second Son, then the person taking the control from you will not need PlayStation Plus. I hope this video was helpful. If you guys enjoyed this content, please support my channel by hitting that thumbs up button. And if you're new to the Beastly Gamer channel, hit that subscribe button. I'm the Beastly Gamer, and I'll see you guys next time.